हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. वेलकम टू JCE कनेक्ट. माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर श्रीनाथ घिवारी फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, जैन कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, बेलगावी. सो टुडे विल बी डीलिंग विद द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द मॉड्यूल 4, दैट इज गेयर ड्राइव. सो व्हाट इज दिस गेयर ड्राइव? गेयर ड्राइव्स आर पावर ट्रांसमिटिंग डिवाइसेस विच आर ट्रांसमिटिंग मैकेनिकल पावर फ्रॉम वन एंड टू द अदर एंड. सो different types of power transmitting devices are rope belt devices, chain mechanisms. Chain mechanisms which you have observed in the cycles, which are connected to two gears and the chain is connected in between which, and we are pedaling the cycle and it is transmitting the power to the rear wheel. So the same you might have, the rope belt you might have seen in flour mills, where you go for converting wheat into flour, wheat flour. So there you might have seen that a motor is connected to a belt, and the belt is connect, the other end of the belt is connected to the rotor. So when the motor rotates, the belt rotates, and because of the belt rotates, the grinder which is there in the flooring machine will also rotate. So these are some power transmitting devices. So what is, so the gear drive is the one which transmits mechanical power, and it is transmitting the power for a shorter center distance positively and with a constant velocity ratio. The whatever velocity ratio is there, which is maintained from one gear to another gear, it is maintained constant. So you can see that there are two gears which are meshing with each other. This is larger gear, this is smaller gear, also known as pinion, and these two are meshing with each other with their teeth. This is known as teeth, gear teeth. So these are totally known as gear tooth. Okay, so these are moving in opposite direction to each other. So the next comes, what is meant by a gear wheel? So a gear wheel is a toothed wheel which has two teeth on its periphery of a cylinder or a cone or sometimes some elliptical discs. So this is a gear wheel, so which has teeth on its periphery. Okay, so this teeth may be formed on a cylinder or a cone. So in the next, so this whatever gear is there, it is keyed to a shaft key. You can see there is a kind of gray color key. This is keyed to this shaft and placed over which on a shaft. Okay, so gears are keyed to this shaft, and two gears are mounted on each of the driving and driven shaft. So what happens is, so these gears are placed on a driving shaft or a driven shaft. Driving shaft is one which is driving, and driven shaft is one which is driven by the driving shaft. Okay, so these two driving and driven shafts are connected by using the gears, so that in this driven and driving shaft we are keying the gear, and the gear is keyed, and so that the gear teeth is meshing with the another gear and transmitting the power from the driving shaft to the driven shaft. So you can see in this in the graphics that the A is moving in opposite direction and B is moving in the opposite direction. So these both are moving in the opposite direction, that is driver and driven gear. You can see the image how it is working. So in this way the power is transmitted. This is connected to one shaft, this is connected to another shaft, this is driving, this is driven. Okay, so now the turning gear of one gear will cause turning of the other in the opposite directions. Okay, now next is, if the two gears have the same number of teeth, if the driven gear and driving gear have the same number of teeth, then it rotates at the same speed, and whatever turning effect is there, it will be not changing. It will be changing only in terms of magnitude, not in direction. If the machine gears have different number of teeth, then the whatever magnitude and the torque is there, magnitude of the torque and the speeds will be changing. That is, if the small gear is having fewer teeth and large gear is having more teeth, then it will increase the torque and reduce the speed of the driven gear. If it is that of opposite arrangement. That is, a larger gear driving a smaller gear will decrease the torque and increase its speed. So it means that if we are using a small gear that drives a larger gear, then the speed will be reduced, but the torque will be more. Torque is nothing but the force into distance. And for the opposite arrangement, that is, if the larger gear is driving the smaller gear, will decrease the torque and increase its speed. Okay. So here larger gear is driving and smaller gear is driven. But here smaller gear is driving and larger gear is driven. So the next is types of gears. So there are different types of gears. So first we'll study about spur gears. So spur gear is one in which the axis of the driving gear and the driven gear are parallel. So see, so this is connected to a shaft, this is connected to a shaft. So these both shafts, which are driving and driven gear of the shaft, are what? Parallel to each other. And the teeth of these gear wheels, whatever teeth of the gear wheels are parallel to the axis of the, which are parallel to the axis. You can see that this is parallel to the axis of this driving or axis of the shaft. We can see over here. So these gears are parallel and this is connected to the shaft and which is rotating. So this is a pinion gear, this is a gear wheel, and the distance between the two is known as center to center distance of the two shafts. So in this, whatever teeth is there, it is parallel to the shaft. That is a spur gear. So now, as I have said, in this, the axis of the driving and driven wheels are parallel to each other. The teeth are cut to the circumference of the cylinder disc. So teeth are cut on the circumference of the cylinder disc. The contact between the mating gears will be along a line. Hence, spur gears can transmit higher power but leads to noise. It is widely used in machine tools, automobile gearboxes, and all general cases in power transmission. So these are mostly commonly used in most of the power transmitting devices. Types of gears, another is helical gear. So helical gears are similar to the spur gear, but the teeth are cut in the form of helix around the gear. So these teeth are cut in the form of helix around the gear, and helical gears are used for transmitting the power between two parallel shafts or non-parallel shafts. As you can see here, these are two parallel shafts. That is, this is one shaft, this is one shaft which is connected to a gear. These are two parallel shafts. And here it is two non-parallel shafts. So, and this is a driven gear and driven shaft. This is driving shaft. Okay. So this shaft is like this, and the shaft is going through, it is like this. So these are perpendicular to each other, or we can say cross helical gears. So these are crossed to each other, therefore they are non-parallel gears, okay, or non-intersecting shafts. So in this, whatever, this is of the curvilinear nature, and the contact is progressive, so which extends the diagonally across the meshing teeth, and starting at first end of the pair of engaging teeth, then a little further along, and so on. By this time, the next pair of the mesh will be contact, so that the engagement will be continuous and there won't be any backlashes in this type of gears. These type of gears are preferred to spur gears when we require a smooth and quiet running of the machine at higher speeds. So this is the way how these helical gears move. And the main disadvantage of this type of helical gear is to produce end thrust of the driving and driven shafts, and these are generally used in automobile power transmission. So you can see that this is the way how the helical gears are rotating. Now we'll discuss about the parts. So in this, the teeth are cut in the form of helix. These are parallel and non-parallel shafts. They are the curvilinear contact is progressive, so that there is no delay in the contact of the teeth, and they are working smoothly and quite running at the higher speeds necessary. And the disadvantage is that it is providing a end thrust, so that it is pushing the gear till it reaches the end point. Okay, so it is providing a thrust to it. It is providing a force to the driven gear. So these are the different types of gears. Few more gears are there, which will be continuing in the next class. If you have any queries, can contact me. Thank you.